What's up, Baltimore? Thanks for joining me on Taste the Charm, where I'm gonna show you the best food and drinks in Baltimore. Today, we're at Topside, where bartender Anna here is gonna show us her spirit-free cocktails. Let's go check it out. Hi, Anna. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
So can you tell me a little bit about these drinks and where the inspiration came from?
Yeah, so I mean, non-alcoholic drinks are definitely something that there's a demand for. We get asked for them constantly, and you know, we kind of, for a long time, had the servers especially coming up and saying, you know, my guests want something non-alcoholic, and we ask for a flavor profile, and then we make something up, which is great, and it's wonderful to be creative, but it's even better if someone can have like a go-to list and be able to kind of make their own choices and, you know, just have some options to choose from. So that's kind of how it got developed, especially with Dry January was the first thing that kind of I ever heard them talking about as something we were going to do, and I don't drink myself, so I was like, oh, like, I would absolutely like to help Anna develop this and create these different options. The response has been really wonderful. I've been just really moved, honestly, personally, by like how much everyone's been really excited about it, because I mean, there's a million reasons why you might not want to have that one more drink or a drink at all, and this just gives people like kind of the confidence to, you know, keep having a wonderful experience with something fun, something interesting, something tasty, without feeling like any pressure that can come along with, you know, an alcoholic drink. A lot of the drinks, or a lot of the ingredients, are stuff that we already have on hand, like, you know, lemon juice and hibiscus syrup that we feature in other cocktails, but I did want to introduce some other elements that are a little bit more unusual. So like, instead of whiskey, I use lapsang souchong, which is a really smoky Chinese tea, so that kind of brings a different depth of flavor that, you know, is something we wouldn't be carrying on the bar otherwise. There's other things like Giffard makes an aperitif syrup that kind of mimics Campari. There's another, actually a local guy, Matt Spinozzi, makes a functional botanical cinchona tonic that's like a concentrate. So that's not on this menu yet, but it's gonna be in my next one. Because that's a really fun thing, is they're letting me play with it seasonally. So these aren't gonna all stay the same. This is kind of what's happening right now. And then as it gets into spring and summer, I'll be able to play with like more fun, brighter flavors. So I've got some cool ideas to come up for the future. But this is kind of a good like intro menu, just kind of looking like some, you know, some of the flavors are going to be familiar to you, if whether or not you're a drinker. So that just kind of makes them a little bit more approachable and, yeah, just really fun to engage with.
Great. So let's try one out. Can you make the, how about the fizzy lifting drink?
Absolutely. And this one I really like, because I was actually, this was kind of my go-to mocktail, if you will, when the servers would just come up and ask for, you know, something for people to enjoy, and you'll see why in a second, because not only it's really easy and flavorful, it's hibiscus syrup with fresh lemon juice. I use a little bit of these Feed Brother rhubarb bitters, which are glycerin-based. They do have some like alcohol extract in like the flavoring process, but unlike something like Angostura or Peychaud's, which are very high in alcohol, these are a non-alcoholic base. There's just as much alcohol as in like mouthwash or vanilla extract. So I do have a little disclaimer on there. So somebody for religious reasons or is like truly trying to abstain, and just, it's all about comfort level, because you want everyone to just feel confident and comfortable ordering these and just be able to enjoy it even more that way. Exactly. I mean, that's the whole thing, is, you know, people just want to come to a bar to be taken care of, and that can look like a lot of different things. And so this is just another way for us to embrace everybody who comes in here and just have something fun. So I just top it with the Little Fever Tree Club soda, and I like adding it into the tin because it already kind of mixes the flavors there for you, so that when you're ready to pour it out, it's already all mixed together.
Wow, that's such a pretty color.
Thanks. And that's why I love doing this one too, because, I mean, when this walks through the dining room, everyone sees and everyone's kind of pointing at it and like, ooh, what's that? And it's like, well, there's no alcohol in it, yet you still want it. Well, I mean, and the other good thing about these is that a lot of them are actually adaptable. So if you say, I really like the look of all these flavors, can I get this with vodka or with gin or with rum?
Right.
They're very easy to adapt to that. So it really is kind of two menus in one, if you think of it that way.
Do you have people commenting, you know, I'm not sober necessarily, but I'm glad you have these options?
Absolutely. And I mean, especially, you know, we have people traveling to Baltimore, especially for so many different reasons, and some of those might be medical. We have so many like hospitals here, so we have a lot of people staying in the hotel for those reasons, and they might not be able to drink, or, you know, their loved one might not be able to, and so they don't want them to feel left out, and they want to make sure that they can still have a good experience together. So yeah, so that's the fizzy lifting drink.
Beautiful.
Yes. I think you should. Absolutely. I mean, that's the good thing about these.
Mm-hmm. I could see if you did want to put a little bit of vodka in there.
You know, you absolutely can.
Well, thank you so much for making this for
us. Absolutely. Thank you so much for being interested and having me.